McGrath, the sergeant said, would you like to make a soldier out of your son Ted? With a scarlet coat and a big cock hat, Mrs. McGrath, wouldn't you like that? Let me do raya, papa did da. Do raya, do raya, would me do raya. Ronnie used to go off the drink for long periods, and one time, it would have been in the 70s at some stage, he was off the drink for a long time, and he fell off the wagon with an unmerciful thump, and he was in an awful state the next day. So he came up with an idea that he had to go to a meeting of some kind in town. So he jumped into the car and he drove towards Dublin, and he stopped on the main street in Bray. And this was about 10:30, 11 in the morning. And he walked into Linehan's, I think it was, which was across the street and just up a little bit. And it was a lovely bar, but he pulled up outside and he went in ostensibly to use the toilet. And he walked in through the door and he signaled to the barman for a gin and tonic and made his way to the gents. And he passed a lone customer sitting at the bar, nursing a pint. And when Ronnie came out of the gents, he stood at the end of the bar and he lit a cigarette and he contemplated the gin and tonic, hoping that it would have the desired medicinal effect. And this single customer along the bar looked at him sideways and said, I thought you were off the drink. And Ronnie took a drag out of his cigarette and he looked at him and he says, I am, he says. I have a gin and tonic every now and again, he says. I find it helps me to mind me own business. Would you like one? There was an old woman, she lived in the wood. Willa, willa, wall, yeah. There was an old woman, she lived in the wood. Down by the river, so down. One afternoon, as we were walking along the banks of that wonderful Seville River, we sat down on an old bench because Ronnie said he wanted to tell me something serious about himself and music. I said, fair enough. Anyway, to make a long story short, he simply told me that he wanted to be a ballad singer. And what did I think about the idea? I said that truly I didn't know because I'd never heard him sing. He was taking flamenco guitar classes at the time. Sing me a bar or two of some ballad, Ronnie, I said, and I'll give you my honest opinion for what it's worth. So there and then he set out on that lovely song, Nora. O'Casey's from the Plough, I think. Well, he sang it in such an unusual way, with great feeling and in that raspy voice of his, that I was immediately convinced and advised him to forget the flamenco and head back for home. He took the train from Madrid the following day and on to Dublin. And that's the gospel. I remember the day that the barrel shade fell into a concrete stair. What the horse face said when he saw him dead, well, it wasn't what the rich call prayer. I'm a nabby short, was the one the retort that reached unto my ear. When the going is rough, I must be tough with my galpine's fusilier. The very reason why I am slighted so by thee. And of course they came to the attention of the RUC, and they were thrown in jail for their own safety, I think, you know, and the car impounded. And of course the next morning Ronnie woke up after been off the drink for like 6 or 8 months and having, you know, a massive hangover, and he was in an awful state, and he woke up facing this brick wall, you know, with all this graffiti written on it, like, you know, I love the Queen and the Queen rocks and all that kind of stuff, and, you know, up the IRA and all this kind of stuff. And he turned around and Barney was on a bench on the other side of the cell, and he says, Barney, for Jesus sake, he says, what kind of a fucking hotel did you book us into? Well, Mickey Maloney raised his head when a bottle of whiskey flew at him. He ducked and landing on the bed, the whiskey scattered over Tim. Oh, be daddy revives and see how he rises. Tim Finnegan rising in the bed, saying twirl your whiskey around like